yourself. Now!
So, yeah, as you probably know already, not a lot of people know what the Crusade of Romanianism is. And the problem is not that those persons are not aware of what those movements advocated for. The actual issue starts when those retards decide that they're just gonna spew shit on fronted websites just to propagate their agenda and cry over fascism. But you probably already know this stuff, so let's move on. To give you a little historical background, the Crusade of Romanianism started off as a splinter group of the Iron Guard, since it was founded by Mihai Stelescu, a high-ranking Iron Guardist who became disillusioned with the Legion. Another important figure that later joined the movement was Panaiti Strati, who was distancing away from a movement, this time placed on the far left rather than the far right. And of course there was also Alexandru Talex, who was more busy with the administrative parts of the group and the newspaper, but that doesn't mean that he didn't write articles for the movement. He's also important to mention because he's one of the main members who survived the dissolution of the crusade, unlike Stelescu and Ristrati, who both died with the movement. In order to understand what the crusade was about, let me clarify some comments that lobotomites like to make about what the group advocated for. No, they weren't fascists at all, and in fact they spoke against the ideology multiple times, despite the fact that Wikipedia considers it controversial to defend people that had no ties to fascism or Nazism. And I defend those persons in this regard because Panaiti Strati was actually harassed by fascists during his trip to Italy, and he threatened to leave the movement if anything sympathetic was said about the regime in Italy. The only thing they considered useful about other ideologies is studying them and considering what works best for this land, but that's about it. And this analysis doesn't only include fascism. For example, Panaiti Strati thought of Trotsky's idea of democratization within the Communist Party, but again, you won't see this mentioned anywhere because people are more busy crying about inexistent things as the crusade actually being sympathetic to fascism, which is, as I said, it's something really false. And it's kind of sad that this misinformation is spread on purpose, even with, you know, me actually translating the manifesto of the movement. So there's like no excuse of actually doing this stuff, but I think that those people actually don't care. So now that I started talking about the movement's opinion on different ideologies, I will explain further what their beliefs actually were. The first and foremost principle that you'll see in their works is the fact that they wanted to create something unique for the nation, taking both elements from the left and the right. There was also an emphasis on libertarian principles such as freedom of speech, bottom-up hierarchy, and some other minor elements that I'm going to touch on later in this video. Think of the ideology as some sort of libertarian Strasserism, with the political position of them being between fascism and communism. And I mentioned the fact that they were between those two movements because the crusade criticized both of them in different ways. For starters, as is the case with the bundle of sticks ideology, they weren't big fans of totalitarianism and corporatism. And in the case of Hitlerism, they didn't approve of the industrialist and imperialist lines of it, and were willing to keep a distance from both right-wing ideologies, even when the extent of Nazi and fascist terror wasn't fully grasped, because this was the interwar period. As for the Bolsheviks, Panaiti Strati just took one visit to the USSR and he was horrified by what he saw. He criticized Stalin for, you know, his collectivization programs that brought the deaths of millions of Ukrainians, as well as the terror that the regime brought to the population. Also, the Crusades saw Marxism as lacking in the analysis of the human soul, being nothing more than empty promises to the workers and the people of the nation. And they weren't fans of the Marxist concept of the proletariat either, stating that it is only a pretext for the justification of the Red Dictatorship to happen. And instead, they wished for all the parts of society to come together and be transformed into a workers' nation. Although there was some sympathy coming from Istrati in regards to Lenin, stating that he was an absolute monarch who worked for the nation, because, yeah, there was some weird, like, elitism going on in the Crusade of Romanianism. Furthermore, some of the controversy comes from the fact that the crusade was actually anti-Semitic, although this only came from the fact that the Jews actually controlled most of the Romanian market, and they only cared about the minorities in the context of anti-Romanianism. That is, as Panaitis Strati makes an analogy, if you remove the sofa, there's still gonna be adultery happening, so... You know, if you remove the Jews of the equation and don't change anything, then the same shit is gonna happen. You can think of their anti-Jew sentiment as something similar to the economic anti-Semitism of Gregor Strasser. Another important element that needs to be brought into this video is their dissatisfaction with the political parties present at that time in Romania. Their criticism mainly went from the fact that each party was a cheap copy of something they saw abroad. For example, they saw the Iron Guard as an extension of Italian fascism, or the Romanian Communist Party as an extension of the Russian Bolsheviks, and so on. The objections to legionarism span further than just the basis on originality, as you can probably guess from the history of the crusade. Mihai Serescu was a complete opposer to the bloodshed that Codreanu was promoting, stating that there needs to be a spiritual revolution between anything violent can happen. And apart from the difference in tactics, Serescu also criticized the authoritarian nature of legionarism. He saw the unquestioning of the bosses and the skepticism of people who were not in the party as something absurd, and accused Codreanu of hiding his true intentions and guilt. And what a better way of proving that you're not a savage anymore, like Strelescu said, than to assassinate him on his hospital bed in the most gruesome way. Because this is what happened to the leader of the crusade. And with that, the movement never went anywhere because he died shortly after the leader of it, you know, was assassinated. And that's about it. I hope I made it clear what the Crusade of Romanianism was about. Don't forget that I have an Instagram page and a Discord account where you can contact me. So, yeah, see you next time.